Okay, I want to talk about loading horse hay, taking advantage of a good thing here. I think I'm going to title this The Power of Observation and Loading Horse Hay. Some people ask, you know, how many loads can you get on a bale, or how much hay do you buy at a time? Or when I find good hay, you want to take advantage of what kind of hay. If your horses like it, go back and get it. You know, if something tastes good and my horses like it and I'm looking for it, then I'm going to go back and I'm going to try and get as much as I can, stock up for winter. I know storage is an issue and keeping it is a problem, but a truck can carry quite a few bales of hay. If you look at my truck here, this is about 20 bales of hay. And this guy out here was giving away some free hay out here, so he said come by and get what you wanted. And so I came out here and looked at the hay and went, hey, it's pretty good hay and it's free, so let me load up here. And so I got about 20 bales on here. The sun's probably going to glare out here. Now I could probably get a few more bales on here. I've got them loaded in what's called a V-load. I could probably get a couple more on top, maybe a couple more back here. Probably get 25. My tires are looking a little stressed. You figure 50 pounds of bale, if I got 20 on there, 1,000 pounds in that bed, it's a pretty good payload. I don't want to do a Dodge commercial, but it seemed to carry it okay. But anyway, you know, if you find good hay that your horse likes, my horse likes his hay, so I always make sure and get it. And if I can find it, and before it either goes bad or goes away, I'm going to get as much as I can. So if you're in the area and you're looking for free hay, you know, this hay out here is pretty good. So, and again, I titled this, I always talk about pay attention to your horse. Pay attention to detail. You know, whether your horse likes food or when they're grazing, look at the way they pick through blades of grass. Look at what they're doing. And I'm always stressing, you know, your horse will scream and communicate at you if you listen. The problem is most people don't listen, don't know how to listen, or have never learned or taken the time to pay attention. And pick up those little things that a horse tells you with those ear flicks. And always be watching. And don't just take for granted that, you know, if somebody tells you something, that, you know, that's the way you got to do it. Listen to your horse. See if your horse is going to tell you if that's a good way. See if your horse will tell you that'll work. And I don't know who's who was paying attention. And hopefully somebody out there is watching this video and they're recognizing why I call this The Power of Observation. I just wanted to kind of... Man, this ain't free hay. This is some hay on the side of the road. And I didn't even get this hay here. And the reason why I was talking about paying attention to horse and paying observation, I've been sitting here talking about this hay, and I just loaded everything. This hay didn't come from this stack. This is grass hay, and this is alfalfa hay. This is stemmy and kind of dusty, and this is nice. I got some good oats in here. This is an oat rye mix. So, totally different hay. And I don't know, hopefully somebody out there will say, man, I knew when you were talking, I was like, that truck, that hay on the truck don't even look like the hay he was loading. That's because it ain't. This is alfalfa, and this is oat rye mix. And I got this hay, and I kind of, somebody asked me a question about loading hay or something, and I was like, well, okay, let me try to mess with people a little bit and just teach them how sometimes just because what you hear, if your eyes are telling you something's wrong or maybe it doesn't work out. Listen to your instincts sometime, especially with horses. So many times people do things, it's like, you know, my trainer said to do this and it just didn't seem right. Some lady put a comment the other day that she left her horse with her mom, or her mom hired some new shoer, and a new shoer came and was beating a horse. And the mom was like okay with it because the lady said she was a trainer. And the mom didn't know. So she's like, you know, since she was a trainer and she was beating a horse and she was doing a feed, I figured she knew what she was doing. Just because somebody calls themselves a trainer, a clinician, I'm a John Lines trained expert, I'm a Pat Pirelli trained expert, I'm a, you know, I went to Clinton Anderson, you know, people want to connect themselves with good horseman stuff. Hey, you should be able to tell if a person knows what they're doing with a horse by how the horse responds and how they handle. And you should know if that person knows what he's doing or if it doesn't just, I call passing a smell test. You know, if something doesn't smell right, you probably ought to take a second look. And hopefully when you were watching this video, somebody kind of went, you know, that hay looks different on the back of his truck than what he loaded. Now, you weren't paying attention to it, and of course, I was trying to keep you not focused on it because I was talking about loading and free hay, and you were looking at a whole bunch of other things, so I distracted you. which is exactly what trainers and all these people are going to do when they get you out there with a horse. They'll start talking about feed and calming and supplements and chiropractors and this special shoe and, you got to get this carrot stick or this special rope or this special tie. All that crap is distraction. And when you distract somebody, it's pretty easy to get them unfocused that you don't know what the hell you're doing or that you're screwing up the horse or that you shouldn't be treating a horse the way you are. So just trying to get you thinking out there and be aware. It's pretty easy to trick people. If I hadn't told people this is different hay and there was free hay out here and I just loaded this hay, most people would not see the difference. And now that I've told you it's different, it's probably very easy to tell that this hay looks really different than the hay over there. Hopefully the camera's picking it up. Maybe I'm just seeing it and I'll go back and load a camera and go, oh crap, they look the same. Now I feel like a dummy. But anyway, that's paying attention, observation, be aware of people trying to tell you things and trying to get your focus on something else other than what you probably know or think, you know, something ain't right here. So I hope that helps on, messing with hay. See ya.